Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and on today's video we'll be making something different. And as you can see, I'm holding my canvas today. So we'll be painting, and I have here with me a medical doctor to be and an artist. So yeah, can you tell us a little about yourself and why you are into painting?
I'm not a medical doctor to be, I'm a medical student.
Yeah.
they seem like they're the same thing, but they're not the same thing.
Okay, in the nearest future, you'll be our medical doctor, so.
Maybe not. There's a possibility.
No.
I'm not a doctor. Okay. I've always liked painting, like since primary school. I've always wanted, whenever we do fine art,
mm-hmm.
I've always participated. There was a time the whole class molded something with clay. And then I went to the dictionary looking for things to paint. And then I saw the picture of a cat.
Mm.
And then I painted it.
So that was your first painting?
That was my first painting. And then I saw another image of rats. And then I painted like both of them in the same. I took both of
cat
them separately.
And
I painted them. And then, since then, I've drawn like with paper and pencil. But I've not really painted. But I've always wanted to paint. I think from 2018, I put it in my to-do list that I'm going to paint. I was always looking for where to learn to paint. Then suddenly I had this like compulsion to paint, and I went to go and buy oil paint and brushes, and then I painted.
So you started painting before you actually went to learn?
Yeah.
Wow.
I was going to paint.
Mm-hmm.
And then I decided, okay, let me test out the colors that I bought and then the brushes, because the different types of brushes have different type of strokes.
Mm, yeah.
So I needed to know what kind of brush gives me what kind of stroke, to know how to use them while painting. So I was testing out the different colors, and while I was testing that, an image sort of came out, and then I decided, okay, I'm going to paint. But I wasn't really satisfied with what came out, and I felt I needed to know more about what I did before, so I went to a class to learn.
And then you've been to an exhibition, right?
Yes, I participated in an exhibition that was called Maroc. The theme was Moroccan painting. It was organized by the gallery where I was studying, where I was learning painting. So I participated with them. It lasted for 1 month. Yeah. Have to pay to register your art, because by the way, when they are done, they give you a certificate. But then the payment entails the certificate, and then they price your work. Because when you create a painting, you can sell it like that. But for it to be official, they take it to someone, and then they price the work, the technique, the price of the canvas, the amount of paint you use, the quality, and then they give it the price. And then the gallery also advertised the painting on their site for like a year.
So how do you combine school and painting at the same time?
Painting doesn't take that much
time.
For example, most paintings I've done within the space of 6 hours. The only painting that took more than that, so it needed really small. It was a painting I did as a gift to our faculty for the 20th anniversary. It had a lot of little details, so I had to come back. But and then there was another painting that was really large as well. That took maybe like 9 hours, 2 days. But most of the times, I just sit down on a Saturday, and then I paint, and so it doesn't really
take much of your time. Mm-hmm. So you know how to manage the time and all that. Wow, that's really great. So today he will be coaching me. As you can see, we're going to just stay tuned and watch out what we're going to create. Yeah. And then if you really want to have some portraits of yourselves, you can contact him.
In fact, I think for now, if you get a canvas and you just give me the canvas, I should be able to paint, because I'm trying to learn, I'm trying to practice.
Yeah.
So I should be able to paint for you free of charge if you can just get the canvas.
Okay, for a start.
For a start, yeah.
Wow, thank you very much. I will show you some of the works he has done, like the pictures of some of his artworks. And if you're interested, you can contact him. I will drop his details, his Instagram page. Also, he is a poet. Like, he writes, if you read his poems, oh my God. Just follow him on Instagram and then check out all his write-ups and all his artworks. So let's get into the video. So we're about to start painting. Stay tuned and watch. So we're going to start with the color.
So the paint, we're using red, white, and black. We're using
black and white.
Yeah. It's black and white, so.
Okay.
So first is to paint the. First thing is to divide the this thing into half less.
Okay. So, like this.
Yeah. Take your water, let your brush.
Make sure your brushes are always wet.
They're actually very similar.
Yeah,
that you have people that actually do art with makeup. Sometimes the best, like when we want to paint, we often make mistakes thinking it has to look orderly.
Mm.
But sometimes the best painting come out from something looking kind of chaotic, because then it looks more natural.
So this is chaotic.
Yeah. It looks like it's scattered, but that's what makes it. When it looks too calculated, it comes out unoriginal or robotic sort of. The last thing you add when you are painting is white. Because when you finally add the shadow, the dark part, then you add the light, because it gives
brighter.
Yeah, it makes it look dreamy. Because usually you have places where light shines on the part of the surface where it shows white.
Like, there's no mistake in art.
Everything is art if you can explain it.
Yeah. But then we can't even explain it.
That's the problem. There's this image I saw that it's sort of disappointing. but she's one of the most prominent artists. She drew something like this.
Yeah.
Maybe yellow and brown, just a single line. And that was the painting. But because she's so good at translating her idea from this thing to words to other people to understand where she's coming from. She won the award. She was recognized as one of the best female artists.
Hmm.
When if you just look at her painting, you kind of be questioning what it means to
like
what
does this mean? What is she doing? I'm seeing it now.
As long as it's smaller than the first one is coming from.
Can you see our feet?
You see,
you know,
you see it's starting to
come out. Can you see where we're headed?
But it's in English as well. The pass by limit.
Yeah.
I really like this part.
Yeah, I loved this part. This is me with my umbrella.
Don't worry, don't worry about it. The person has shape.
It's just not visible. Are you ready to see this?
Unveiling.
This is not boxing. We are unveiling the artwork, the final look. Are you ready? Oh my god, just look at this. Can you see? Wow. I don't know what to say.
Walking through a forest, woods, and snow.
Can you see this? The rain.
Actually, we're not done.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, one more step.
One more step. And we're
one
done.
More step.
Okay, so this is the final one. Let me come closer. Can you see? It's raining. That's why I have my umbrella, as you can see. Yeah. So this is the final work.
Use the card to...
to get the rain, yeah.
Rain.
Okay, so thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like, share, and drop your comments below. Check him out on Instagram. Yeah, thank you.